Let's talk about polynomials, because that's what all the cool kids are doing. A polynomial is something that looks like this. 3x cubed plus 2x squared plus 5x plus 7 or something like that. And another polynomial could look like 8x to the fifth minus 3x plus 9, or it could be like 22 over 7x to the 42 minus 3x to the fifth plus nothing. It could just look like that. So polynomials are amazing. And if I wanted to be super obnoxious, I could put a negative sign here. So the point about a polynomial is it's got a couple of features. One of the features of a polynomial is that all these exponents are positive. Positive. Come on. Slow. There we go. Integers are positive integers on anything that you have. Oh, come here. So any of your exponents here, so these are all exponents. Exponent, exponent. Remember, this is an exponent. It's a secret exponent. It's one, that kind of thing. So I could throw a one in there. Why are we slow? So that could be a one. So, but it's still a positive integer. Again, there's a one. There's a one. There's a one. All the exponents have to be positive integers. Now, the constants, or the coefficients can be anything. So coefficients, so these are the exponents, the yellow things. The coefficients, these green things, those can be anything you want. The coefficient is the thingy that appears in front of the letter. And I've read like math textbooks that have official definitions of those. But I always say thingy in front of variable, in front of variable, always works and it makes more sense to me. The thingy in front of the variable, that's the coefficient. And they are allowed to be anything that they want to be. Okay? You can have pluses and minuses. So you can add the individual terms. And then a lot of times they can have, but they don't have to have, this little term at the end, which is called a constant term. They can have a constant term, which is basically number with no variable. Okay, so they can have a constant term, and that's, exactly what we're looking for. So another thing that we can talk about when we talk about polynomials is we can talk about the degree of the polynomial. And the degree of the polynomial is the highest exponent. Not like the tallest, but the largest exponent. So the degree for this one would be 3, because that's the highest exponent. The degree for this one would be a degree 5. And this would be a degree 42 polynomial. All right, so that's just some basic vocabulary. The leading coefficient would be so I'll write that leading coefficient is basically the first coefficient if you have them in order. So like these are all in order, like the cube, is it bigger than the squared? Is it bigger than the one? Is it bigger than the nothing? So the 42 is the biggest exponent. So you could also say the leading coefficient is a coefficient in front of biggest exponent if it's not in order. Okay, so that's not too bad. So we've got a couple of words, coefficient, degree, and leading coefficient. Those are kind of your vocabulary words when we're talking about polynomials. But aside from that, a polynomial is just a simple looking, not simple. Okay, simple compared to other things. It's nice because it's got all integers in the exponents, all positive integers in the exponents. Everybody's happy. It's a polynomial. It's like the person you invite to every party is a polynomial because you know things are going to go well. Okay, so let's talk about how to add and subtract polynomials. And it's actually pretty straightforward, which is kind of fun. So if we're looking at a polynomial, let's say we have something like x plus 5, which is a polynomial, right? Because, you know, it's got a integer as a, what do you call it, exponent, and as a constant term. So let's just say I have x plus 5, and I have another polynomial called x plus 7. You're like, I'm confused, because I've been doing stuff like that forever, and we never called it addition to nothing. So let's say we had x plus 5, and we wanted to add x plus 7. So again, you've probably already done this before, but what we're going to do, since it's added by a plus sign, all we have to do is rewrite it and combine like terms. So we have x plus x, and then 5 plus 7. So x plus x would be 2x, 5 plus 7 is 12. Look at that. You know how to add polynomials. You've been doing it for ages, you know, ever since you were knee-high to a pig's eye or something like that. All right, that's really all the adding polynomials is combining like terms. So if I had x squared plus 2x plus 5, and I was going to add it to, ooh, we'll do that, 3x squared plus 5x plus 7. All right, again, what we're going to do is we're going to combine the like terms. So we have a squared terms to go together. We have the regular x terms that go together, and we have the constant term that goes together, that go together. So we have x squared plus 3x squared, and then we have 2x plus 5x, and then we have 5 plus 7. I'm apparently obsessed with 5 plus 7. So there's our squared terms that go together. There's our x terms that go together, and there's our 5 plus 7 terms that go together. So we've got x squared plus 3x squared. So if I have apples plus 3 apples, is I have 4 apples. Almost wrote apples. So I have 4x squared. 2x plus 5x, 7x. 5 plus 7 is going to be 12. So we can see how those are created by following the colors. Okay, not so bad. Now, let me give you a very similar problem, but I'm going to throw one of the terms just out. So let's say I had x squared plus 2x plus 5, and then I'm going to add it to 3x squared plus 7. Okay? So this is a very similar problem, except not all the terms have a match, and that's okay. So x squared and 3x squared still go together. Now 2x lost his partner, that's okay. He just doesn't get added to anybody, so we don't have to freak out. We don't always have partners for everybody. And then I have 5 and 7. Okay, so I have x squared plus 3x squared. And I have 2x by itself. And then I have 5 and 7. So x squared plus 3x squared, the 2x by itself, and the 5 plus 7. 4x squared plus 2x plus 12. So it's a different answer because it's a different problem, but I guess what the point of this is don't freak out if not everybody has a partner to get added to, okay? Similarly, don't freak out if you've got negative signs inside those polynomials, you just have to be respectful of them. So let's say I have 5x squared plus 3x minus 5, and I'm gonna add that to 2x squared minus 4x plus 1. So we're going to continue to combine like terms. So the x squareds and the x squareds go together. The pinks and the pinks go together. Sorry, the whatever you call those. X's and x's go together. Now, you see that minus sign. If that minus sign is freaking you out, some people like to write it as a plus a negative 4x, and that's okay as well. Okay, so whatever makes the most sense to you is the way you need to do it. The negative 5 goes with the 1. And again, if it makes more sense to you to write the negative 5 as a plus a negative 5, that's completely valid and you'll still get the right answer. 5x squared plus 2x squared. So that's the first part. Then I'm going to add the 3x and either plus a negative 4x or just write it as minus 4x. So however you get there, it's good. And then we have plus a negative 5 plus 1. And there you go. Okay, so now it's just a question of adding those coefficients. So we have 5x squared plus 2x squared, so that's 7x squared, plus, now 3x minus 4x is actually going to be a negative x, so plus a negative x minus 4. And I can go ahead and write that as 7x squared minus x minus 4. And again, you can see where these come from by following the colors. And if you don't have colored pencils, that might be a good idea. If you're kind of struggling with this a little bit, using colors for your homework can definitely help. So 7x squared minus x minus 4. So that's what we're looking for. Subtraction of polynomials, basically the exact same thing, except with a subtraction sign. So if I have 2x squared plus 5x plus 3, and oh, let's do something simpler to start with. Let's just say I have x plus 5. X plus 5 minus, I should know what I'm doing before I start. 3x plus 5 minus 2x plus 1. Okay? So 3x plus 5 minus a quantity, 2x plus 1. The biggest thing you have to remember here is that this negative sign distributes across to each of those terms. So the first thing you have to do, so you've got the 3x plus 5, don't just start off trying to combine like terms. The first step should always be to distribute that negative. So minus 2x and then minus 1. Then you can combine the 3 and the 2x. So 3x minus 2x is just straight up x. And then 5 minus 1 is just straight up 4. Okay? So the biggest thing with the subtraction is not to forget to go ahead and distribute that negative before you get started. It can be a little complicated. Honestly, negative signs is just where all things go bad, tends to be. Like pretend that had been a minus 1. So whenever I distributed that negative across, I've got 3x plus 5. Let's try it again. I've got 3x plus 5 minus 2x. But now the minus, a negative 1, turns into a plus 1. So when I combine them, I still get x because that part didn't change. That part didn't change. But here I have 5 plus 1, so that's going to give me a plus 6. So paying attention to those negative signs is really important. Aside from that, you're going to do them just the same way that you've been doing them prior. So I had 3 x squared plus 5x minus 3 minus 2x squared plus, 2x squared minus, 3x plus 7. Okay, so if you kind of feel like you know what's going on, go ahead and pause the video and see if you can get this figured out on your own. If not, just play along and you'll have plenty of time to practice this kind of stuff. Again, and if what I'm saying isn't making any sense, I strongly recommend going to other videos and seeing if they explain something in a way that just makes a little bit more sense than how I'm making it maybe not make sense. But I'm going to start off by distributing that negative sign all the way across. I really recommend not skipping the step of just rewriting this out without the parentheses. So minus 2x squared minus a negative 3x makes a positive 3x, and then minus 7. Okay, and if you're like, okay, I got that, I think I got the rest of the way, pause the video again and try to go ahead and finish that out so you can see what's going on. So we got these that are combined. 3x squared minus 2x squared. We have these that are combined. 5x plus 3x. And we have these that are combined, minus 3, minus 7. So we've got 3x squared minus 2x squared is just 1x squared, or you can just eventually take the 1 away. You don't need the 1 because it's implied. 8x minus 10. So again, x squared plus 8x minus 10. You should be good to go.